The Big Clive Pixies have been kind to us and we've scored a couple of free batteries. Let's test them out and then we'll make them safe to use in our projects. Our first battery is still lodged inside its pretty grotty container. The top has already been lost and we can just pull the base off with some pliers. I'm just going to push the contents out with a screwdriver. Now don't worry, I did check that I'm not poking the battery. It's pretty disgusting and it is covered in the special magic fluid. I'll remove all the horrible bits. At this point I started to regret not wearing rubber gloves and went for a bit of a hand wash. Snipping off the atomizer, I did get a bit of a fright and thought for a brief moment that the battery was about to go up in smoke, but it was just protesting a bit at being chopped off. Let's just watch that again in slow motion. With all the junk removed, we can tack on a couple of jumper wires and connect it up to this little charger board. I'm also putting it in a metal dish just in case I need to carry it outside and dump it. These charger modules use a TP4056 chip and they also include a DW01A battery protection IC along with a dual MOSFET. The schematic for both the charging and battery protection circuits are pretty much an exact match for what we see in their respective datasheets. On the charging side of things, we have two LED indicators for charging and fully charged, and we have the resistor for programming the charging current. My PCB has a 1.2K resistor, which according to the datasheet will give us a charge current of 1 amp. Talking of PCBs, this seems like an opportune moment to talk about PCBWay, who sponsor the channel. If you're in the market for a PCB, then check them out. There's a link in the description. After an hour or so, the battery charging is complete. Now the battery says it's got a 500mAh capacity. I've hooked it up to this battery capacity checker and will let it discharge. Assuming the capacity is correct, this should take around 1 hour as it's being drained at just over 500mA. So, an hour has passed and it's fully discharged. Amazingly, it's saying it's bang on 500mAh. Let's have a look at the second battery. This one seems to have been run over. The outer casing has been completely destroyed. Initially, I thought that the battery had actually been squashed, but comparing it with the first battery, this is just the shape they come in. Checking it with the voltmeter, we get around 3.7 volts, so this battery is also not completely dead. Once again, I'm stripping off all the nasty bits and tacking on some wires. With it connected up to the charging board, we get up to a healthy 4.2 volts before charging cuts off. Hooking it up to our capacity testing board, this second battery comes in at 566mAh, another great result. So looking at this battery tester got me thinking. It's not doing anything clever, we should be able to recreate it with parts we already have. There's a 0.02 ohm shunt resistor, along with an op amp for sensing the current, and there's a MOSFET for switching the load into the circuit. Under the display, there's a 7-segment driver and an MCU. I've linked to a video in the description that has a teardown of this device, along with some details on why it's not very accurate. All the board is really doing is measuring the current and then integrating that over time until the battery voltage drops below a threshold. This gives us the amp hour capacity of the battery. Now I've got a whole bunch of ESP32s lying around, including this one with a nice colour display. So I've got something we can use to show the results on. The ESP32 also has a built-in analog to digital converter, so we can easily measure the battery voltage. Since we know the resistance we are discharging the battery through, we can calculate the current and sum that up over time to get the amp hour value. I've sketched out this very simple circuit. The ESP32 only goes up to 3.3 volts, so I've got a simple voltage divider of two 10K resistors to halve the maximum 4.2 volts the battery will output down to 2.1 volts. To discharge the battery, I've got a 5 watt 7.5 ohm resistor, and I'm switching this into the circuit using a power MOSFET. This will let us switch off the battery discharge when the voltage drops too low. The battery will continue discharging through the 20K divider, but we're not going to be leaving it connected forever, so this should not be a problem. I've also added a little indicator LED to the gate of the MOSFET so we can see when it is turned on. With the MOSFET turned on, the total resistance that the battery will be connected to is 8.6 ohms, so we'll use this to calculate the current flowing. I've also measured the potential divider resistors to make sure my voltage calculations are as correct as possible. Having said that, the ADC on the ESP32 is notoriously inaccurate, so we'll only really be able to get an approximate value without doing some calibration. It's also very noisy, so I'm taking multiple measurements and then averaging the result. The software is very simple. We start off in an idle state with the MOSFET switched off. When we connect the battery, we see the voltage go above 4 volts and switch into the measuring state. We then turn on the MOSFET, reset any calculations, and start to accumulate the current we measure over time. When the voltage drops below 3 volts, we switch back into the idle state and turn off the MOSFET. The battery capacity can then be read off the screen. It works pretty well. We're in the same ballpark as the other battery tester, though both that and our DIY version are going to be pretty inaccurate. My measurement of the total resistance when the MOSFET is turned on is probably not very accurate. My multimeter is a pretty cheap one, and we are dealing with the ESP32's very inaccurate ADC. I've also recorded the battery voltage on the serial monitor every second, so we can plot the discharge curve of our cells. This is the 500 mAh cell, and this is the 550 mAh cell. Looking on the web at some reference curves, we've got a pretty good match. It's always nice when an experiment matches the theoretical result. We can also get an estimate for the internal DC resistance of the batteries. We can see that the battery voltage under load was 4.078 volts. Assuming the battery is fully charged to 4.2 volts, we're dropping 0.12 volts in the battery. Given the current of 0.474 amps, we can calculate the internal resistance to be approximately 0.26 ohms. This is obviously very approximate, given all the errors in our system. Obviously, both my DIY version and the one I brought are on the very cheap end of battery testers. There are professional ones that will give you much more accurate results. But I'm going to call this a win for DIY. I like my homebrew version. I've tested the batteries a few times, fully charging and discharging them, and they've both been pretty consistent. So, we've got a couple of healthy batteries. You would think we can go ahead and use them in our projects. Well, not so fast, Batman. Eagle-eyed viewers will have spotted there is something missing from these batteries. There is no battery protection board. That's fine if we always use our charging board with the built-in battery protection, but we really should not use these bare batteries anywhere else. We need to make them safe. So I bought some battery protection boards. These boards feature the DW01 protection chip along with the dual MOSFET. It's exactly the same circuit as we have on our charger board. I've tacked on a couple of wires to the output pads, and I've soldered the tabs to the battery tabs. Everything is now wrapped up in Kapton tape, and we've got a couple of safe, free 500 mAh batteries. We can see this in the discharge graph. I've changed the code so it doesn't turn off the MOSFET unless the voltage drops below 2.5 volts. But as you can see, when we drop to 3 volts, the battery protection cuts in and we drop down to 0 volts. This makes our code turn off the MOSFET. You can also see the effect of the battery's internal resistance. As soon as we remove the load voltage, the voltage from the battery jumps up above 3.0 volts. It's all very interesting stuff. So, small bit of bonus content. I decided to invest in a slightly more sophisticated battery tester. This has a lot more functionality and it comes with a nice OLED screen. I've tested out the 500 mAh battery and this device reports it as having 440 mAh. Our 550 mAh battery comes in at 567 mAh. We're still getting pretty good results for both batteries. This device also gives us the battery resistance. It's in the same ballpark as our calculation, so that's nice as well. If you're looking for a good battery project, then you should watch my keyboard hack video. It's really good.